there was cinder block on the floor over there. The tables were all upended. Everything was just shattered. It was terrifying.
An early morning shift at a restaurant turns into chaos when a car slammed through the front wall. Fortunately, no one was hurt.
But now the business is suffering. They can only serve at half capacity. NBC2's Samantha Serban is showing you the damage at Zarate's family restaurant in Englewood.
Right here where I'm standing is where a car rammed into this restaurant Saturday morning. You can see the scuff marks here on the floor where the tires flew in and the tables were pushed out.
Plywood boards are a signal to anyone pulling up to Zarate's family restaurant that something is damaged. Rhonda Lopez says damage could be an understatement.
My coworkers and I came in to open up. We open up at 6:30 in the morning. And so we were preparing for the day, obviously. And just all of a sudden, it sounded like this bomb went off. I mean, the whole building shook, stuff falling from the ceiling. And come to find out, we had a car run right through our actual wall.
You can see here the red Ford is sitting in the dining room covered in debris. A 76-year-old regular was behind the wheel.
He said about five times that he was completely embarrassed about what happened. He felt really bad.
Turns out the driver had accidentally hit the gas instead of the brake. Fortunately, he walked away with only a scratch, but he did lose his appetite.
But then he says, well, I don't feel like I'm up to breakfast today. And I was like, oh, honey, there's no way you were going to get breakfast anyways today. We're going to be closed.
Closed for 3 days and now only serving half the number of guests they used to, employees say things could have been a lot worse.
Some of the sheriffs that showed up said, we were going to come for breakfast, and they would have been sitting right there.
Not being able to use the side, I mean, obviously we're losing a lot of revenue. My staff is losing pay, you know, so it's affecting everybody, but thankfully everybody was safe, and that's what honestly matters the most.
Next up for Zarate's is figuring out when they can get this room fixed and ready to go. They're working with contractors now to get this place open again soon. I'm reporting in Englewood. Samantha Serban, NBC2.